How you doing? My name is Howie, just your average hyper-Jewish guy from New York. In 1996, I wanted to become a children's TV show host in China, so I took stand-up comedy classes with a bunch of 6-, 7-, and 8-year-olds. They became my best buddies in Beijing. My classmates were known as China's new little emperors, as Chinese couples are only allowed to have one child. They grew up amidst the most tremendous economic and social changes the world has ever seen. Studying with these kids was a life-changing experience and helped me become a real Beijinger. And on my 34th birthday, we held a party that none of us will ever forget. I came back to Beijing to work on the Olympics, but I really wanted to find my old classmates. I wanted to see how they had turned out, and through them, to understand the massive changes that China has undergone over the last 12 years. But first, let me take you back to 1996, when it all started.
您好，来了。哦，叫你过来。好。哦，您到了。您迟到，今天。不是，您等会儿，您迟到。怎么了？您进您不拦就来晚了，您进门还高呼大嚷，我您干嘛呀？您是。我们同学迟到了都有个表示，您要一点表示都没有，进门您还喊。
那怎么罚我呢？
不是得罚您，得先起码有个表示意思，就得就是我迟到了，起码有个意思，你知道吧？您这连个意思都没有。
嗯。
就好，应该迟到似的。哦，对不起啊。哎，
刚才没给我回来，没办法。我坐那儿啊。那就找个空位。
好。开门。行行行行，赶紧坐。哈哈哈哈哈哈！为大家表演，我非常高兴。等会儿。
I studied comedy with my classmates every weekend for almost 2 years. These kids are a unique social experiment. They're the first generation of children anywhere in the world to grow up without brothers or sisters. While their parents were raised chanting slogans from Chairman Mao's Little Red Book, they are growing up with McDonald's, Coca-Cola, and Kentucky Fried Chicken. Their parents live solely to ensure that their child has a better life than they did. But you've got to remember, this is their one and only chance.
妈妈，我就觉得他来到这个班以后吧，记忆力提高的特别快。跟老师当堂吧，就是让孩子把东西背下来。老师说一段，就让孩子当时你就重复，看能不能记多少。所以他通过学习这个以后吧，记忆力增长的特别快。就在学校里边学的那课文，我是回家从来没让他背过。他自己吧，全都能一字不落，一句不差，全都能背下来。This
is Mrs. Ma, our teacher.
这都不对的啊，就用眼光这么一扫视，哎，这就表示，亲爱的观众朋友们，下面由我来为你们来表演了，你们大家伙要注意看。叮当彩罗烧香放屁，不是别人就是他。Mrs.
Ma has dedicated her life to teaching children stand-up comedy, known in Chinese as Xiangsheng. She teaches at the Children's Cultural Palace in Beijing. As far as I know, Xiangsheng is still taught in only a handful of places in all of China. In Xiangsheng, two performers tell jokes, recount stories, imitate famous people, and so on.
Yeah.
Liu Hongjun is one of the funniest kids I've ever met.
外号，
胖子。
会吃吗？
会。
饺子会吃几斤？
那要那个要分锅，要一块儿吃，能吃三四锅吧。那个哥哥
穿红衣服呢？
啊，这是我。
你最喜欢吃什么呢？
那个麦当劳那个，不喜欢吃多了。那豆角、麦当劳那汉堡包、炸鸡腿，
主要的就行。
炸鸡腿还有那叫，就想起来了，那叫什么？可乐，喝的这不是喝，还有那个黄瓜、豆角。
刘恒军，你长大的时候要做什么呢？
当相声演员，出国挣大钱。
刘恒军 is a total natural.
妈妈来了。
His funniness.Must come from the warmth and love of his family. They know he wants to become a comedian and will do anything they can to help him along this path.
你今年多大岁数呢？
七十九。
七十九。你有几个孩子呢？
就这一个孩子，一个爸爸。
一个孩子。
哎哎。哦。一个孙子，一个儿媳妇，一个儿，咱们四口。
特别疼你这个孙子吧？
啊！
学他不要学的就……
哎，学习他就特别粗心呢，特别为他着急。可是我要是专门把精力放到偷的那学习上，把他这个自己的那点特长或特点都给耽误了，我觉得就是那个能跟上他，有一旦他意识反应过来以后吧，他能赶上去，因为他不是特别笨。我知道他不是特别笨，他一直猛醒过来以后，他能跟上，所以呢，让他学点他喜欢的，这点就是启蒙一下，是吧？到他大了呢，他就有基础了。
不得的烤鸭，黄中透红，红中透亮，勾人吃欲，引人饥肠。您取一张荷叶薄饼，放于桌上，加两块烤鸭，蘸匀甜酱，选几丝羊角，松白平放极上，把饼轻折两折，放入口中品尝。只觉得满嘴流油，软而不烫，外焦里嫩，是越嚼越香啊！
我说你为什么迟到？我告诉你，让你明天是不是九点钟来啊？
是。
那你怎么回事啊？还带着象牙蛋，抹着红嘴唇，这你怎么没忘？就把九点钟来上课给忘了。我说什么你就哭。行，你走吧啊。
This cute little crybaby is my number one stand-up partner.
Hello. Hi, Francis. How are
you?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
I'm fine.What is your name?
My name is Wang Fei.
How old are you?
10岁半了。
那你长大的时候你要做什么呢？
我长大想当医生，想把全国的青年全给治好。
那王一飞，要是你有一个愿望，一个心愿，世界里什么都可以得到，你要什么东西？
我要一本书。我要长知识，给全国做好事。
大哥，看你照片吧。
好。
哎，你别找了。
大哥哥，你看这照片。
王一飞，你最喜欢哪个呢？
我最喜欢这张和这张。
王一飞's mother works as a clerk.While her father is a retired professor of Russian. They are a bit old to have such a young daughter, and this begs the question of what happened to them during the Cultural Revolution. The Cultural Revolution, which lasted from 1966 to 1976, is said to have set China back at least 20 years. 13 and 14-year-old kids were sent to the countryside to learn from the peasants.While people with education like teachers, doctors, and lawyers were reformed through labor. Anyone now over 50 years of age was affected, and the scars run deep. We can just imagine the dreams that this Cultural Revolution generation has for their children. Children who will be able to grow up free from the political turmoil that deprived them of their youth. Beijingers are some of the warmest and most hospitable people in the world. These pedicab drivers are my local homeboys. They give Beijing its character and have been working in the same beat for who knows how many years. You see, Beijingers are a lot like New Yorkers, rough on the outside but tender on the inside. They're a proud and warm people who have a good sense of humor and love to talk and eat. They know how to hang out and are ready to give you an opinion on anything, even if they have no idea what they're talking about. They can bullshit with the best of them. And that's why Beijing is the center of Chinese comedy. Going to a Chinese person's house, besides being a total feast, is also the only way to really get to know someone. And I warn you, you better be prepared to eat. And it's not just the adults who take care of you. The kids are also wonderful hosts.
Hey, Zhao Yingxin. Hey, 你好.
This is my classmate, Tang Meng. She took me to her school to celebrate International Children's Day. That's the day when first graders become members of the Young Pioneers, kind of like a Cub Scouts for future members of the Communist Party. Today, which just happened to be my birthday, was also one of the funnest days I've ever had. Being able to bestow the gift of laughter on these kids was the best present I could have ever asked for. And for the kids, well, they've all been to the Great Wall, the Forbidden City, and the Summer Palace. Seeing a crazy foreigner prance around on stage must have been better entertainment than going to the zoo. I was truly touched. I even became an honorary young pioneer.
我上个星期没上课，因为我去美国了，看我妈，我妈给我看了你们的录像，特别的高兴。对，我妈，我妈给马老师买了一个小东西，鼓掌。马老师是我们的伟大领袖。那个英文的绕口令好吗？好，好吧，我先说一遍啊，你们都跟着我说。哎 ，Peter Piper，
Peter Piper，
Pick the pepper，
Peter Piper，
Pickle pepper，
Pickle pepper，
How many pecks？
How many pecks？
Of pickle pepper，
Peter Piper，
Did Peter Piper pick？
Peter Piper pick。
我说一遍快啊，你们听着啊。Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. How many pecks of pickled peppers did Peter Piper pick? How many pecks?
To repay the kindness shown to me by these kids and their families, I decided to throw the ultimate birthday bash.
Party. Party. Party is 什么意思？谁知道？
生日。
生日是 birthday。Party 是怎么说聚会吧？来，我叫你名字，你过来，我给你的请帖好吗？过来，快点。好，红明给你这个。
这个吗？您没谢人家。
江源，恭喜恭喜，今天的最佳女奖。哎，那天你们要吃什么呢？
我吃鸡腿。
鸡腿一个一个的，前面是什么呢？
生牛肉。
什么？
生牛肉。
生牛肉。你呢？
我要吃肯德基，我要吃那个麦当劳。
The big day finally arrived. I told their parents to drop them off at 9 and pick them up at 4. I was psyched. It was gonna be just me and 20 of my best buddies for the whole day. Thank you. Mrs. Ma was having a good time, and that made me happy. A bit of free advice to anyone out there thinking about taking the plunge into the China market. You've got to capture the hearts and minds of Chinese children. There are 250 million children under the age of 12, and each kid is the center of attention for at least six adults who will do anything they can to ensure that their one precious child gets whatever he or she wants. I had McDonald's cater the party. Mickey D's is looked at as a high-class establishment, as fast food, shiny floors, and service with a smile are relatively new concepts in China. And McDonald's has just blown the market away. I get a little plaintive now thinking about that day. These kids represent the dreams and desires of a lost generation. They're going to meet all sorts of candy men on their journey to adulthood, and all we can do is hope and pray that they choose the best path for themselves.
我希望能跟他们接触很长时间，好几年，看他们长大，看中国的变化怎么样，通过小孩，可以研究一下真实一点。爱国在中央，爱国在中央，爱国在中央，爱国在中央。
lot has happened since studying with my comedy kids. China has undergone the fastest economic and social transformation the world has ever seen. 12 years ago, there were barely any private cars. Now, 1,000 cars a day join the streets of Beijing, and luxury stores catering to the new urban elite dot the cities. Buildings are going up so fast, even the locals can't keep track. And Beijing has become a playground for architects from around the world. These past 12 years, I've been to many places and done a lot of interesting things.
I want to thank the Communist Youth League for their great support.
我要谢谢共青团, 你们的支持太棒了。
Despite everything, I always find myself coming back to where it all started, Beijing.
我是外国人,不是外地的。我是北京人。你吹牛逼呢。牛逼他们。吹牛逼呢。我觉得有,我就给你信。你大胡了。咱俩同性恋,不会。
I found that while many things remained the same, others had changed beyond recognition. With all these changes, I really wanted to find my old classmates. I started by finding Mrs. Ma.
中国人没有那习惯,我没见过。是,你赶紧高兴就行了。我来,有事儿。啊,有事儿。我要找咱们当时是二年前的那帮孩子。就你做那录像那帮孩子呀。是。哟,那可难了。现在是北京的变化太大了。
Mrs. Ma still teaches comedy at the Cultural Palace. I decided to sit in on her class to see what these new kids were like.
Hey,
kids are still coming to the Cultural Palace to study all sorts of extracurricular activities. I decided to first visit Liu Hongjun. Mrs. Ma told me he was living near his old house, which had been demolished to make way for a new development, like has happened all over Beijing. His parents were curious about the old movie, so he reminisced about the simpler days of his youth. Liu Hongjun didn't become a famous comedian, but he pursued his interest in the arts and wants to become a filmmaker.
Now, Hongjun,
you're still making films? 反正这个当时挺实验的，因为受蔡明亮的影响比较大，里面有好多那个象征的东西、隐喻的东西。你知道那个美国那个
Jimi Hendrix，
The God of Guitar，
作为一个家长啊，
哎呀，觉得这孩子那么有天赋，他又那么勤奋，他又那么好学，他又那么好表现，特别期望他赶紧出名儿，让他出名儿，哎呀，都认识他，要不然他就长大了。这种功利心带给孩子很大的不好，没有免费的午餐，你得自己去奋斗，一切都得靠你自己。
It's hard for a teenager anywhere to figure out what he wants to do in life.Let alone in a super competitive country of 1.3 billion people.
哇，解放军同志们，您辛苦了。过年好。
谢谢谢谢，过年好。
哇，谢谢了。过年好。
谢谢谢谢，
过年好。
过年好。
辛苦了。中国解放军好。
Most Chinese value unity over individuality and conformity over freedom.
How are you?
刘航俊 has grown into a unique young man.And is trying to break the mold. He grew up when China opened its doors to the outside world, yet managed to remain grounded amidst all the changes.
现在我觉得中国人还不够了解自己的文化，还不够了解，或者说经历的太多的外来的事物的冲击吧，还没有能够真正的达到一个和谐。我觉得这是最关键的。我特别不想看到的事情就是。我们以后的孩子，他们不知道自己是中国人，他们只知道自己是麦当劳人、肯德基人。我觉得这是一个挺可怕的事。我现在的状况就是，我跟同龄人的代沟非常大，但是我跟老人有时候能够交流。
Every New Year's, there are temple fairs scattered around Beijing. They date back to the time of Kublai Khan and are a great place to come and hang out with the locals. On this day, me and Wang Yifei joined 100,000 other Beijingers at the Temple of the Earth.
你记得小的时候我问你要长大的时候要做什么，你记得你说什么了吗？
我说的是医生
啊。
嗯，
就改行了，
改行当老师了。
Wang Yifei has turned out to be a real party girl, and I don't mean the type that goes club until 4 in the morning.
你是那个什么团员吗？
哦，我是共青团员。
共青团员，
嗯，
那个会变成党员吗？
要交入请，要交那个入党申请书，才就是那个党要批，所以我才能进。
She is a product of the new China, and wants to become a member of the Communist Party. The Beijing Olympics, sending a man into space, the return of Hong Kong, these are all points of great pride to the Chinese people. She, like many of her generation.Wants to contribute to the development of her country.
我觉得中国现在进步很大，是所有的人，也就是，都是尽力去配合国家的一些政策，相关出台的一些政策。所以，我相信，中国会越来越好。
那你爸这几年在中国吗？
不是啊，他去俄罗斯啊。
他去俄罗斯做什么呢？
他在大学里教书。
I wanted to watch the movie with her and her mother. While many people have upgraded to new cars and new houses, her mother felt embarrassed that she was living the same life as she was the last time we met and wouldn't let me in.
看这个最想就记得你的同学什么的，看你自己也特别感动吧。
为什么就没继续学呢？
因为要学习了，因为小时候可以有课余的时间，然后比较自由，但是上了随着年龄增长，那个学业一些课时也会变多，学的东西越来越重要了。
那你高考是不是很辛苦啊？
高考对于一般中国学生来说都是一个非常重要的一个环节。
I called Wang Yifei a few days later and asked her why she cried. She said she was amazed at how fast time flies and that she longs for those simpler days of her youth.
来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来来
汤梦。
好久没见，怎么样？
走到这边。
你1.73米？
差不多都要1.75米了。
是吧？
这儿这都是新的小区吧？是吧？
对，都是新建起来的。
咱们两个有几年没见面？
应该是12年。
哦，那时候
就是我八岁，那就是八岁。现在20。
现在在上学？
对，马上就该毕业了。
在学什么呢？
学法律文秘。
好，开门。
行，赶紧坐。
那天好像是你生日吧，也还是快到你生日了，可能我记得是吗？然后是我们校长，然后是个女的，然后就是我们，好像是给你是不是？
对，红领巾。
好像是、
这个、
对，送了，应该是送了你一个相册。
对对对。
好像是我记得是，因为那天也挺深刻的，记得。
同学对你有没有什么说什么吗？
就觉得好像。认识个外国朋友，反正觉得挺好的吧。
但那时候你觉得奇怪吧？一个外国的成年人要跟中国的小孩一起学习，你当时
可能当时我心里没有奇，反正就觉得挺好奇的，好奇比较多。奇怪，没什么，就是好奇，还是觉得挺好玩的一件事。对，
我当时也是，
挺好玩的一件事。
因为学外语跟孩子交流是最好的学习的方法。
对，我觉得孩子就是。他说的话都特别的，就是真实。
Tang Meng hadn't seen Mrs. Ma in over 10 years, so we headed over to the Cultural Palace.
搬到哪儿去了你？
就在新街口那边。
是新街口，我找你，给打电话。你怎么就不知道你给我打个电话呢？
常都忘了你电话了。
我承认你忙，你可能没时间看我，也没时间到少年宫来，但是你。你要说一个电话都没时间打，你说实话，你想过我没有？
在电视上看见过你，
那都没想起来给我打个电话。
没有你电话了，根本就我中学就是小学毕业之后就上中学了嘛，不知道我们
家。其实你家离新生少年宫特别近。
就不拍迁了，不就不住这儿了吗？我初二就回求奶奶家住了，广安门那边。
哎，你现在如果让你们俩再演当年的小品，你们还能演得了吗？
我得看那词儿嘛，
没有词儿吧？基本没，都是他的词儿。
对，上街理个发去，上车去那长城饭店，再给我150块。
我是小偷啊，是吗？
对，
你不让我坐吗？我得找座啊。然后站起来坐那个，
我把那个
坐这儿。
The local English paper published an article about Mrs. Ma, and she wanted to know what it said.
这是2000年你得了文化部的一个奖。
对，就给一证书，什么也没有，一分钱也没有。
对，然后呢？对。
说我一个月能挣1000块钱。
这1000块钱。
哪谁给我1000块钱？
然后不是特别
富裕。我少年宫才给我500元钱，哪给我1000块钱？
然后就是。
那明天是不是9点钟来啊？那你怎么回事啊？还戴着象牙，戴抹了红嘴唇，这里打这些英文字跟我说的话是一样的吗？
是，
完全一样吗？
是。
那你要到国外一放，人说这个女人怎么那么厉害？
Mrs. Ma was born in the quickly disappearing Beijing alleyways known as hutongs, and became addicted to Xiangsheng in childhood.
真跟相声接触的那是很小的时候了，大概是8、9岁的时候吧，我就呢去模仿。一模仿呢，我家里的父亲母亲呢就是很生气，就说一个女孩子学什么不好，为什么要模仿这个东西？这东西不要模仿。
She has had a difficult life and suffered greatly during the Cultural Revolution. She is a side of China that people are trying to forget. but you only have to scratch the surface of anyone of her generation to hear a similar tale.
那么我的父亲和母亲呢，无意当中把这个领袖的字给贴倒了。我呢，替我父亲母亲把这个罪顶下来，因为我父亲母亲岁数年纪很大，经不起这运动的这个冲击，结果我就把这事情揽下来了。来了以后呢，就戴着这个我们中国叫帽子啊，反革命的帽子，就到了东北，一直在东北一共待了五年。我那生活呀，苦是很苦，都是很苦，不光是我苦，就是很多的那些青年到时候都很苦。我那时候最容忍不了的是孤独，因为人家呢是个集体，互相之间有个照顾，就是你病了我可以照顾照顾你，哎，你家里有事情我们可以帮助帮助你。可是我是作为一个反革命分子去的，很多人在政治上的原因都躲开我。
那你是怎么安慰自己呢？
回忆相声，唱歌，回忆当初曾经收音机里播放过的相声。人呢，总得活着，总得往前看嘛。
小刺猬，
说实话，这帮孩子们给我的欢乐挺大的，要没有他们，我支持不了现在。
With Mrs. Ma's help, I was able to find my old classmates.
赵迎新。怎么样？
啊，
找到没问题吧？
啊，没问题。上来一趟。
啊，
得亏底下站的都是中国人。
哎呀，是杨帆吗？
杨帆
是不是？
没变样。
怎么样？
哎呦，赵先生，哎呦，赵先生您好，您好。
那肚子大了，但是脸瘦了。
是吧？好，请进。
你好。
哎，你好，王一飞，你好。
那时候戴眼镜。
戴眼镜，黑发很。很黑，
长头发，
对对对，
对对对，那时候太小了，那时候上小学，那时候我还上小学呢，现在我教小学了，
对，挺好的。
It had been 12 years since we last got together, so we were happy to be able to catch up on old times.
后来我不记得您去日本了吗？还是
97年回日本了，然后在国际侦探这个公司搞国际侦探。好多年，
这牛啊，这个牛，这个
跟FBI有啥关系？
业余FBI啊。
We spent the afternoon talking about the good old days. This generation of little emperors had now grown into young adults, and it was fascinating watching them watching themselves. The film brought home how much things had changed in their lives over the last 12 years.
Jar.是谁的家给拆了吧，对吧？谁拆迁就是对吧？一二。
While China has made great advances since opening to the West, there have also been a slew of problems along the way. Demolition of whole neighborhoods, pollution, the end of the social welfare system, massive layoffs, and cities overflowing with migrant workers. These kids have lived through it all.
但是社会发展注定得牺牲掉一批人，我们家铁路这边是可以回迁的，铁路那边他一间房子甭管你多大就给你7万块钱，当时7万块钱跟城里买房也能买10平米。
My classmates were now old enough to ask me questions, and they were as interested in my life as I was in theirs.
可能我第一次8年来中国，我都以为自己跟马可波罗似的，我是探险家。那时候中国也没有什么实际的，没有对吧，我要到中国来赚钱，不可能那么想，但是就觉得尊重差不多就是世界人口1/4的国家，这儿肯定有东西值得学，肯定会有用的。
但是您在中国你经历会有这种归宿感吗？就是到了自己家的这种。
96年我第一次认识你们，我比如那时候想在中国扎根不了，因为我的根在中国的土地上，那个肥沃跟我的生活配不上了。现在可能外国人在中国可以在这儿定居，做事情。
When talk turned to the next generation of little emperors, my classmates seemed acutely aware of how different kids growing up today are from them.
我是跟着我爷爷奶奶一块儿，我爷爷奶奶、爸爸妈妈我，然后我上辈呢，我奶奶是我爸那辈，哥5个。等于我是独生子女，他们是独生子女，但我还是有哥哥有姐姐，是这样。所以这么长起来之后呢，我就不明白其他人是怎么想， 我都搞不懂他们。他们是等于就是跟着父母，没有跟老辈儿，没有跟老辈儿待过的，就是不一样。
我觉得就咱们这帮孩子为什么跟普通的孩子不太一样，我觉得有一个因素，就是咱们是学过，甭管真的假的，学过说相声。
After all this banter, they fell into something more familiar.
家住真定府常山县，破战破胜，后封为常胜将军。
I had long forgotten this piece, but was glad to see the tradition lived on.
张飞一莽撞人，曹操一听，呀。
The kids told me that if I wanted to find real Beijing culture, I should go to Xiangsheng Park. It is a wonderful park behind the Forbidden City, where you can experience the warmth and culture that make this city so great. While much of the city has disappeared, old Beijing remains alive in her imperial parks.While this generation grew up in difficult times, one can feel a certain nostalgia when strolling around these parks. I hadn't done my stand-up routine for a while, so I decided to show them how we do it on Broadway.
那我趁这机会好不容易，我教你们一两句奥运的英语好吗？
好。Welcome to Beijing.
Welcome to Beijing.
I love you.
I love you.
我爱你，对吧？老太太笑着呢。
I felt like the Minister of Propaganda today, and asked them to sing me the Chinese national anthem.
叫什么名字呢？叫什么 ？What is your name？
木子李。
木。
木子李。
啊，木子啊，一个木，一个子啊。
子。
李先生，李同志。
嗯，对。我就愿意这么称呼。共产党好。
China is a mosaic of generations that have experienced everything from the Korean War to the Cultural Revolution, from the opening up to the West to unabashed market capitalism.While each generation lives in stark contrast to the experiences of its predecessors, it was great to see that Beijing culture still runs through them all. We all finally got together to see a Xiangsheng performance. Mrs. Ma had lost touch with a lot of her former students, but we were now reunited through what brought us together in the first place, Xiangsheng.My experience with these kids showed me that you can only understand people by learning about their language and culture. It amazes me how easily people will let you into their lives if you approach them with an open and humble heart. Their acceptance of me has helped me build a life in this vast and mysterious country.I look forward to keeping in touch with my comedy kids for the rest of my life.And see how they, Mrs. Ma, and Beijing develop over the next few generations.
这帽子很帅。
啊，帽子给你。
我们全民学人英语，真的学吗？学呀。所以说啊，那我说 hello。
hello。Bird's nest。
Bird's nest。
Bird's nest。
Bird's nest。
Bird's nest。